Apologize if you guys hear any weird ass sounds in the background. Of course, we have a schedule and a calendar up for all of our important appointments between me and my lady. She's a high-powered Hollywood lady. Gets in my ass every time I don't know her schedule. And walks in here and immediately starts watering the plants right when I go live. Saying, well, I didn't know you were going live. Feel like it's on the calendar. Literally. Every Tuesday. Welcome to the good old stream, homies. I see Agent Arrow checking in. What's up, playa? Oh, it's been a while, dog. What's up, Dirty Sheets McSkeets? A lot has happened since the last time we spoke. It's been a long time. Shouldn't have left me. Bobby Bootleg. Oh, fuck yes. First time on live Switch. That's so baller. Sub Sin for game. Shagath 43. Sub player. Obviously, you guys might notice we got our new emoticons checking in. They're fresh subscribers gain access to unlimited use of the emoticon. But we also have some new commands where you can basically also use them for fun little things. The Yodog bot will sling them out there for you. So I'm hoping later tonight that we're going to go raid Meechow's channel. And we'll go in there. Subscribers will be able to sling Yodogs and throw ice all over them. And do all sorts of fun shit. Flex on fools and ice people. Love you too, baby. My annoyance with you has nothing to do with my love for you. Yes, of course I'm live right now. It's 6 o'clock. Yes.
So you're not live.
That is live. There's an animation and everything.
But you're not live.
There's 26 people listening to this. 26 people listening to this conversation.
Really?
Yes.
Damn it.
Looks like I fucked up and didn't have something on loop. Love you, baby. And while I was distracted, of course, I accidentally started playing today's startup video. What's up, people? Let's put the face on deck. I just shaved today, so I'll show off these units. Sorry for that hiccup, guys. We're official in 3 minutes, starting some tutorial action. Yep, somebody redeemed 4,000 Yodogs for a swag crate, of which we have unlimited, so no worries there. Oh, what's up, Proto Man? Oh my god, what a sick name, dog. Proto Man 2K. TJ Ghost, what's up, player? Oh, it's gonna be so sick today. Lasers for eyes? Oh shit. Cheesy Poops, what's up, playa? Yeah, learned something today. If you're hosting somebody else, you have to unhost them before you try to go live. Sidebound in her house. So they're sidebound using one of the commands that'll authorize the Yodog bot to ice people on your behalf. I do have in the commands, though, that I would rather we use those in defense of the stream versus a raid versus continuously icing people. It kind of devalues the subscribers' access to them, but I wanted everyone to be able to defend the chat versus people jumping in here and throwing their cho balls all over people. We also have a new list of commands. Some cool isms that people have been hitting me up for. Obviously, we got the Yo Dog digital currency full force. Everybody is gaining one Yo Dog per minute right now. So that's still one more name, Chuck and Ern. That is the big announcement for today. Our emoticons are real. They are real. Sidebound, you got 378 Yo Dogs. And we also have the raffle, guys. Don't forget that. The raffle is 250 Yo Dogs per ticket.
Excellent. Andrew.
Bobby Bootleg just followed. Thanks, brother. But of course, we got the swag crate and we got gift bags for 4,000 Yo Dogs and 1,600 Yo Dogs. The swag crate's going to have at least $100 MSRP in it of sick 40K stuff. Angron, of course you will hear Yo Dog from me. We're not there yet. Let me, Alright, 6 o'clock. It is officially Yo Dog time. I'll shout everybody out here in a second, but everyone who got here 6 gets to watch our pre-scripted video that I put together for you guys to show you what's on the table, give you that little intro love. So, Yo Dog, Kenny Boucher here, Next Level Painting, about to hit you up with that sick video. All day. Retro intro engaged. So obviously, this is some dollar store acrylic paint right here. We're just going to use it to do the bases on these Juggernaut that we worked on last week. So I'm just showing you guys real quick dry brush with a really busted ass old brush and a cheap ass off-white, ancient white, you know, antique white or whatever. It's basically bone. And we're just going to dry brush this secret weapon resin base, like wasteland base. Give it a sick, quick, once-over dry brush. Just bang it out super fast. I always like to dry brush the bone color over a good black primer as my, like, ashen waste field effect versus a white. I'll use a white later, but it's, to me, it's a little bit more interesting to not have an actual white be the predominant color there. Have that natural rock color. You know, so obviously, you've seen me do bases before. That's why this is not going to be, like, a tutorial online. This is literally just this is what I did earlier today for you guys. So now we're gonna put a little white on the base, bang it out super quick, easy mode. And those big rocks, we're gonna generate contrast on those big rocks right now. A little German gray. I'm almost out, so you gotta get creative with the paint application. So a little water, pull it out of the pot. Gonna sling this German gray rapid fire over these rocks, super wet. We got some white out on the palette right now because we were dry brushing with it earlier. So now I'm just gonna kind of start mixing some white in too. Wet blend it as I go. I mean, real rapid fire, man. Like with something like this, you literally just that fast, bro. You just start slinging it in there, pull some more of the gray out, blend the colors together. But that's not enough in itself to give those rocks that love. You got to pull out some Prussian blue. Wet blend a little bit in there while it's still super wet. And just give yourself a nice little blue tint to that rock. goes a long way. For some reason, a little bit of blue in a rock looks cool as shit. You know, I don't know why. Because I don't think I've ever seen a blue rock, you know? But I'm not a scientist. I just know what looks cool. You know, banging it out, throw a little bit more white on top. I mean, so informal. Like, this wet blend is just so gangster. And, obviously, though, you don't have to go that gangster. You can be precise if you want. Now we're going to dry fit the base real quick for that juggernaut we painted last week. We haven't finished them yet. We're going to talk about it today. Ancient Chinese technique right here. I don't play games with Peter. That's a fucking power drill, son. That's a drill. Corded drill. And so I'm going to just drill a nice little hole in the bottom of that pewter foot. That easy. Excuse my tiny dog, who doesn't give a shit about my stream either. Always be careful not to punch a hole right through the bottom of these motherfuckers. I have done that so many times. It is a fucking epic pain in the ass. But, you know, you definitely want there to be a nice hole, but you don't, I mean, you'll find out that, like, as long as the rod sticks, you're good to go. So now I'm just going to bang a hole from where we dry fitted it out on the resin base. Super easy. The resin goes quick. I'll punch a hole all the way through this base, though. And these little brass rod, I get these from Privateer Press. They have cool little sets that match their drill bits. They give you, like, ten rods and, like, three extra drill bits. It's so clutch. And now we're just going to put a shitload of glue in the bottom of this mofo. Get that pin up in that hole. And match it up on the base the way we had it laid out. And then we're just going to clip that extra off. Super easy. Not hard at all. Now, here's ancient Chinese technique right here. You might be interested in seeing. So obviously, this juggernaut was not built properly. You can see his front feet are kind of dancing. He's kind of doing a myrtle shuffle. Or I guess he's sea walking. I don't know what he's doing. But this is how I fixed that with these pewter models. I just, bang out a quick little piece of cork. Chop it up. Put a couple of notches in that motherfucker. And then I always keep one side kind of skinny. So that I can wedge it up under his foot. So he's like he's on a rock. So it's not like he's levitating and doing a dance moves. I see that my boy Clay Cruz checking in. What's up, brother? So there it is. Glued that fake rock up under his feet. It's looking good. So we're going to glue anywhere that he's levitating off the ground because his improperly built pewter dance pose. We're just going to throw rocks up under there. And then just same kind of protocol with that Prussian blue and that German gray. Bang it out super quick. You know, little bit more, keep it a little bit less real here, like less gangster here, because you know you don't want to fuck up all that pre-shaded airbrush we did last week. And you know, get it in there, get it wet blended. And you can see that is such a sick technique. Like a lot of people, they glue their guy on and see, fuck, I got the angles wrong on the pins, everything. You got to pin these pewter models on their bases, so they're just gonna break off. That's like rule one. The next rule is like you can't always get them. Brass rods super straight, and sometimes you're gonna create weird angles that are gonna lift the model off the base. We have a tutorial on this on YouTube, like a real for the Yujing. We do the same thing here. This is just something I've been doing for a long time. What's up, Absinthe? Checking in. Cydrian, what's up? You know, quick little highlights right here, and this is obviously, guys, anyone just tuning in, that we're just covering a quick what I did earlier this week video for you guys, so you can get caught up on where we are with the juggernaut. Of course, I did a bunch of details on this juggernaut when you guys weren't looking. Just did all the base details, just the trim, everything. I didn't do any actual like washes or highlighting yet. We'll do that today, but I want to show you some of the things that I did this week. So that way, you know, you guys don't see the models involve in huge leaps and bounds, but also I don't want to work on the same model for, you know, 9 streams in a row. Like this will be it for that juggernaut after today, and we'll do something else next Saturday or Friday, guys. Anyway, let's bang out a quick dry brush here. Same deal, some of that antique white. Quick little rough dry brush over that rock we wet blended earlier. Give it some contrast. And here's another ancient Chinese technique right here. Surface primer, Vallejo. This is what I rim my bases with. I don't use normal black. I use this because this is, when this dries, it's like a primer. It's super strong and durable. And those the resin bases are just prone to chipping, especially they're out hanging out there on the edge, you know. So this is definitely, I use it every base. Like, it's just so strong. And there he is, looking good. We, of course, can do a couple more things, you know, before we're ready to do some more work on him. We're going to throw a couple of tufts of grass. This is Gamer's Grass right here. They are an awesome company. My boy, King's Hobbies and Games, he slings them. I think he's the only North America distributor of them. So we're going to throw a couple of these tufts on, make them look pretty. You know, he's doing his little dance. Got some beautiful meadow underneath him. But after all this glue dries and all this paint dries, we got one more thing to do. Jazar checking in. What's up, Jazar? SC Max. Looks like Orgasmic checking in. Okay, here it is, guys. Gloss varnish. Vallejo gloss varnish and a little airbrush thinner. It's the only thing I use airbrush thinner on. Literally the only thing. And we're going to mix it up pretty, a substantial amount of thinner so it dries fast. And we're going to lay on a medium thick coat of this gloss varnish, because it is, first rule one, gloss varnish 10 times stronger than matte varnish, and pewter models, they chip like crazy. So this is the first reason why with pewter models you don't play games. You always hit them with a hard gloss varnish before you matte them back down. And the second reason is that it helps our washes flow, and we're gonna do some washing here. And here's our little berserker guy. Guy rides him with his custom power claw that our boy Brian made for us. And we're going to hit him. He's like, fuck it. We're going gloss varnish. Just hit him too. And also, gloss varnishes, they'll make your colors more vibrant. Even when you come back and matte them down, they'll stay like one, you know, contrast stage up. Like, they'll have a little bit more contrast. So, and also, it'll let the wash flow. And there it is for the video today, guys. Let's jump back into the models on deck mode. All right, guys. Hey, guys. I missed you. So here they are in all their glory. Mr. Juggernaut up here on the left. He is ready to get washed and set aside until he dries. But the guy on the right, I already washed him and already matte coated him. So he's ready to get painted. We'll get some details on this guy. Ridrex. Rix Dread. What's up, player? Thanks for the follow. And also, you notice I left that claw black. His cool little converter claw. It's because we're going to airbrush that shit up. I got some new colors. Some really exciting new colors I have not tried before. I'm going to jump back into the Q&A. See what's going on. My moderator's communicating with me. So I post that video. Yes, post your video. All right, let me check. See, let's do a quick roll call. See what's going on up in the house. Spiky Bitch checking in. That's the world famous Rob Bear. What's up, player? Love you, my best friend. Slow Fuse Gaming hosting. Slow Fuse Gaming taught me everything I know about airbrushing. This guy's a G. He's also a member of the Wu-Tang Clan. You had a great stream today. This Tuesday is The Sun Will Never Set on Blue on Bristlickers United, which is our stream team. Check out the links below. We do have some big announcements, though. Catacouples checking in, one of my other mods. Joe Darkblade in the Heezy. We got anybody else I haven't shouted out yet? Dealer of Death, what's up? What's up? Waffles, what's up, man? Clay Cruz, of course. Killing Time Payton, what's up? Still one more name. Orgasmic.
Excellent!
Lasers for Eyes. Swearjick, thanks for the follow. Love you forever. Anyway, guys, so we got some exciting shit real quick. Slow Fuse, you're the man. So here's what's up. Here's the hype today, guys. Obviously, you guys discovered that the emotes work now. Baller. All subscribers have unlimited access to the emotes, but we do have some commands for defending the channel from raids. I see you guys already discovered them.
I see I'm 1,000,000%. That is better than 100%.
1,000,000%.
My boy Killing Time Payton. Thank you for the sub.
Ooh, yeah.
Welcome. to the exclusive emote category. But also, that leads me to the next point. We are, by my count, one subscriber away from unlocking the second tier of emotes. And if you guys may have noticed them already, if you investigated the channel a little bit, look down at the panels, you may have noticed that we've got two already designed, so that way we'll have minimized lag because it's like a 48-hour approval. So if we get one more subscriber today, I'll be able to submit tonight. And there it is. Slow Fuse Gaming, my boy Jason, thank you, obviously. You're going to be partner very soon, and I'm going to be following your channel and subscribing for all your custom emotes. I can't wait to see those. So that means after the stream today, I can submit those emotes, and they should be activated by the time we stream again, so we don't have that lag. That's why we had them pre-designed. So that's engaged. But so anyway, Flex and Icy, the command that triggers the Yodog bot into spamming the chat. I like to reserve that for defending the channel for raids. We also have a whole new category of commands that our boy Ironheaded, the world's greatest mod, he designed a bunch of Kennyisms. Not my idea, but he literally made me, and him and a bunch of people, like Me Chow made me too. So they will all trigger cool little things. Take a look at them. They're hilarious. Ironheaded designed them.
And his name is John C.
Agent Arrow. Love you, dog. Respect. Can't see me.
His name is John C.
Really? Apotheos. Apotheosis. Apophis, UK. Apophis, UK. Thank you. Yep, you guys are. I'm letting you guys familiarize yourself with the new commands. It's going to be hilarious. I figured that the new commands are going to be like the Rocky Horror Picture Show. Like, you know, when they say toast, you throw toast, you know, kind of deal. So, you know, it'd be fun to play that game. You know what I'm saying? So, let's play along with that. That'll be hilarious. We also hit our benchmark thanks to Ironheaded's sick level of promotion. We hit 1,000 followers. Baller. Appreciate it, guys. And anyone who's new, just checking in for the first time, definitely check out the giveaway and the rewards. Everyone in the stream is collecting Yodogs right now. Everyone. Subscribers, they collect more Yodogs. And anybody who's on my Facebook page, or sorry, my Twitter page and my YouTube channel, they get even more Yodogs. We have our sick raffle, and we have a giveaway. We have these loot crates that you can turn your Yodogs in for. I got unlimited. So anyway, that's what's new on the table. I figure you guys are gonna be going crazy with emotes for a little bit, and before you have a question for me. And that means I'm going to go start working on this tutorial for you guys. All right. Oh, wait. One last thing. I forgot. I had planned this whole thing. No one go crazy with the subscriptions for the next few seconds or anything like that, because it might not trigger right, because I'm going to go to the other screen real quick. I'm gonna go to the least good screen. So, you guys don't know what's in this bottle because Twitch apparently is not okay with liquor, with liquor endorsements. But I'm gonna have a toast to the success. It has been super clutch. Anybody following along at home? Cheers. Can't do it without you guys. We're partner now. We've got emotes now. We got everything, bro. It's only a matter of time before bringing Hybe back isn't just something we say online with a hashtag in front of it. Cheers. All right. Back to the stuff you guys want to see. baller mode. All right, sous chef. Oh, wait, got a little whisper. All right, it's go time. All right, sous chef, these models are about to get painted now. If you like them now, wait till they actually have some paint on them. This is going to be good. All right, moving parts engaged. All the silly shit. Yep. All right, got the ancient Chinese tablet engaged. I thought for a second absinthe said kapla. That's some nerd shit. Dumma e-checked me? Why are you always e-checking me, dog? Get a debit card. It's 2016. All right, guys. This one's for my boy Dumma right here. Hold on a second. Which one should I give him? Because I can pick. I know what my favorite is. Dumma, tell me what you want from your gift for donating. For Gen Z, oh, I missed you too, brother. What'd you forget? Okay. So it wasn't Dumma? Okay, I'm very confused. I'm a look back. Before I do anything. Less than mediocre. What's up, player? Thanks, man. Appreciate it. We got all them new emotes and everything. All right, I'm not gonna do anything. I'm gonna put a pin in this. Whisper to me if I need to do something. Oh my God, I would kill to be a part of a live sex show. But obviously, I wouldn't be the guy having sex. I'd just be the guy filming it. We haven't made one yet, but if you have any cool, my boy, RD Ligart says, how much for a Hulk Hogan gift? Yo, new gift ideas, submit them to me on my personal Facebook page. Slow fuse. Take your time. All right. Whisper to me if I need to do something, Ironheaded. We're going to do this thing. Actually, you can just put it on the screen. It's fine. I can see shit. I got my tablet. All right. So here's the situation. I'm going to get my old ancient Chinese glove out. We got to get a Monday Night Raw with Edge and Lita. Man, it's been a while since I watched that shit. I was watching some, what is it called? God damn it. It's the new shit with the Lucha Libres in it. Lucha something. Fuck, man. I just watched a match with Rey Mysterio. It was so badass. All right. So, this right here is just the pre-shading red tutorial from last week and all the details carefully blocked in. You see? He is glossed, he is ready for his wash, and then he's ready to get matte coated afterwards. And we will do that. This guy is the Korin champion that rides him with his pewter legs and his berserker torso with his custom lightning claw that Brian Mole made for us. Out of, looks like a possessed Space Marine arm. We'll do some details there. But I do have intentions to paint some sick lightning claw effects, some glowy stuff. He was glossed and he was washed very cleanly with the gloss washes. And then he was matte coated again, so he can take some details. So now I'm going to put him down. We'll get back to him and we're going to do some gloss wash on this Juggy Lord to show you why the combo of a good gloss varnish and these new GW gloss washes is so good. looking through the chat. Remember to use that yo dog if you want to get my attention. But it might slip my attention a little bit because the tablet does not have better Twitch TV enabled. Oh, yeah. Dancing Berserker for a dancing juggernaut. Okay, so there it is. So, I was debating whether or not if I was actually going to use the gloss washes. And you know how, like, the church of next level painting is all about these gloss washes now. But here's the thing. Gloss washes are real subtle. And sometimes you want some hardcore shit. But I decided that it'll be the best way because what I really need from this wash is to get a black line in between this gold and this red. And gloss wash combined with gloss varnish is going to do that better than anything. So, these things require a good shake, but here's the trick, though. They get crazy bubbles in them when you shake them up super hard. So, you're always going to want to take your ancient Chinese water bottle lid, pour a little out in there, and then it kind of lets you move around the bubbles. Make sure we're good and focused. All right, so I'm actually going to pull out a detail brush for this. I'm going to pull out a brand new, fresh little brush. Nope, you guys are talking to yourselves. All right, so I'm going to grab a little brush right here, and my goal here is to wash all this metal trim. But what I really need to focus on is getting this wash to flow right there, and that's the money right there, bro. And so since it flows so good because it's gloss anyway, and it leaves the top color really vibrant still, unlike the matte washes, which really dull down and really distort and stain colors, this does not do that. You see we're getting a nice easy flow right here. And the only reason I'm not done with this shoulder pad already is because I'm doing it on stream. Kind of overextending my arms. If it was sitting here, you know, hunched over it, pow, done that quick. But it's actually good that I have to go slow because I learned a long time ago that to be a good teacher, you can't just go at your speed. It doesn't give you enough time to explain things. Learned that from my dad. He was a teacher for 35 years. Alright, so now what we're doing is we're manipulating it, the wash, to pull up around these bolts. And still trying to get that line. And the good thing about this wash is it just flows over. I mean, it just gets in there. Maybe I'm a little too close. Maybe it's too hard to see what I'm doing that close. And everything is so shiny right now because everything is all glossy and wet. It's gonna be a lot of light reflection right now. Same thing. Let's go on this chain right here. And you want to make sure you get a nice little wash barrier between the bright chain and that dark red. Let me move the special Yo Dog tablet. There we go. Paint with my weasel. Now, this is not an eBay hack. This is actually an out-of-print model I wanted on purpose. I wanted the OG metal one.
Excellent!
Vag Slayer. Thanks for the follow, Holmes. I needed a model that I can throw at somebody too and kill them. So remember to use that next level painting when you're talking to me. It's more important now than ever when I'm looking at the tablet. My studio is just not optimized right now, and it will be. As our stream grows, it'll consume more and more of my Beats Lab. Okay, so it's just a matter of going through, and I'm going to focus on the detail areas because I have the detail brush in my hand right now. Make sure everything's in focus. Keep moving a lot. Let's come down here and hit these. And you see just like literally just pow. Dumma, that's my man. Dumma, I love you, brother. Remember, subscribers, they get more Yo-Dogs, and they get more luck in the raffle, too. So, you can see how that washed, literally because of gravity, and we broke up surface tension with the gloss varnish. It just literally found every little thing, every little border it needed to be attached to. That quick. Super simple. I'm also experimenting with a different way of setting up the desktop audio because last week we had a little problem where we lost audio toward the end. My mod and I, we troubleshooted it. We think we found a solution. So I'm running audio in a way that can't be disturbed, but there is a slight chance that I don't hear it when we're airbrushing. But I've done tests and I think I can hear it. Damn, Dumma. I don't know what to tell you. Your bank must be really good. Like, it's like, who the fuck is this Kenny Boucher motherfucker you're trying to give money to? We don't trust this guy. We're putting a hold on your payments. All right. You see, and the good thing here about, and this brush is a little too small for what I'm trying to do here. I'm going to upgrade here in a second. I mean, I don't know if I will, honestly. Sometimes you just got to go slow when you're doing the wash. Because, like I said, the most important part of the wash is that barrier. That black line that we're creating between. And like I said, it's going to look really bad until it's matted down. Like, because it's all going to be shiny stuff on top of shiny stuff. That's just going to look awful. But this is the tech, you know. This is the ancient Chinese technique. So, been getting kind of excited because you guys might not know, this model is for this tournament I'm going to this weekend, this GT called the Hammer Rat GT, Pasadena. He is my Crimson Slaughter Corn Lord for my Chaos Space Marine Combined Arms Detachment that I'll be playing this weekend in a 60-man GT in ITC country with all the Gladius strike forces and triple cad Eldar armies and Death Stars. But I have faith in my Corn Lord. That's why I got him donated to me. And then converted by Brian. But yeah, you see that we're just getting those mechanical parts. Looking pretty good. I mean, good is relative. Damn it! It looks like we got a little spot of wash right there. That is infuriating. I don't know if I can get it off at this stage, but I'm gonna try to flick it off with a paintbrush. Kind of scrub it down a little bit. There, I'll probably have to try to spot check that later. Nah, it ain't gonna come off. So we're gonna have to spot check that little spot later. No stranger to it. Who's trying to get Ironheaded to rant? I'm looking. Oh, you guys are talking about the stupid Twitch alerts being stupid? Oh, thanks for the host, Catacouples. I didn't see that shit. I'm not getting those notifications are too faint for me right now. All right, so bankers, yeah, it's the bankers. Using your brush conditioner laser for eyes. Are you making sure to use it like after every time you use your paintbrush and everything? Maybe you're just harder on your paintbrushes than I am. I mean, they definitely fray. These brushes I buy are cheap, but for the cost, I just buy like 15 at a time. And then with brush conditioner, I can get a lot of mileage out of them. And then when they get frayed, they get relegated to different duties. You see, and this is what I'm saying right here. Gotta get that line. Gotta get that border. See how much better like that trim looks against that red, that bright red at the bottom here? Once it gets that black line in there? And this is all last week's tutorial. We showed you a super the gangster pre-shade technique with all greens, and we use that blood red from Vallejo on this. So that's why his reds are a little bit more muted than the other like Ferrari reds we've been doing. We decided that blood, you can't do corn without a blood red, and I'm glad we went with it because I do like the darker red. I think it's very cornate. And we're just making sure to get this wash, letting it kind of cheat and flow into some of these areas. Same deal with this Chaos Star. And because it's gloss wash on gloss varnish, this is really easy to wash. Like, it's going to start pulling up in there, and you can just start dragging it around. And because this Excellent. Wash... Thanks for the follow, Easton. I think that's my friend James. And because this wash is the surface tension is so broken up, the gravity will just kind of like take it around the edges for you very easily. And like I said, it's going to look like pure shit until we matte coat it, because we're talking about a gloss varnished model with gloss wash on it. Everything is just shiny and hideous looking. But that's like the secret ancient Chinese tech of the GW gloss wash. Can't believe it took somebody so long to just say, fuck it, we're going to manufacture a wash with gloss as its medium. It's GW innovating like they do. So there's that star, getting a good wash built up around it. I'm going to come back and use brown on these little horns. Yep, Easton knows. Player. Now we gotta come and get these details right here. Let me see if I can change camera angles on you guys. Oh, Gamma Goblins. I love you, dog. Man. Thank you for the subscription. Remember, all subscribers get the custom emotes and they earn Yo Dog points faster. Oh, I guess somebody hype him. I guess we can do that now because we have our custom emotes. Ironheaded. Flex and ice this guy. I forgot about that. I guess we can use the emotes for that. The Yo Dog bot's good for something. Alright, so I'm just sneaking these washes in right here. Just like so. Steaming pile of shit until it's matte coated. And the good thing is, like, you can be... If you fuck up a little bit with this wash... It don't really matter because you have time to slide it around as long as you catch the fuck up kind of early. because of the surface tension being so broken up by the combo gloss on gloss. You see? It really doesn't... Make sure we got enough light. See, just... Oh my god, it's just so shiny and so hideous. Ironhide, they beat you to it. They beat you to it. Tonight, I'll submit the new emotes, guys. It'll be fun. All right, got all the light up in here. We're in focus. So on the bottom of his foot, I'm not even gonna give a shit about being methodical. It's the bottom, you know what I mean? It's down low. It can have all that extra wash in there. It's just out on his big forearms where the red is just so tight. I don't want to do a full wash there. I want to do a controlled wash. But down here, you just go beast mode, I'm realizing. And the fact that we have a detail brush right now is so silly. Let me set it down. Let me go over to one of our more frayed brushes. There we go. Move the brush. Are donations coming through and I'm not seeing them, Ironheaded? Because I feel like... I think I'm messing up. I just saw somebody's name in it. Oh, wait. Submission. Yep. All right. I spoke too soon. Yep. I saw the ticker move, and then I was like, something's wrong. That was my man, Joe Darkblade. That man just earned himself, I think, in the neighborhood of 200 Yo Dog points and a John Cena gif. Love you, dog. Love you, homie. Joe Darkblade coming in fresh. And Uncle Bang, he donated $5 earlier, hearing himself 100 Yo Dogs. I think that actually is an e-check that cleared from the last stream. Yo, that's my boy, Mike Haspel, everyone. The honorable Mike Haspel's in the channel. That's Rogue 428 right there. Make sure I got a shit on focus. Alright. So, like I said, get that gloss wash. Get it on this. I mean, in my cast, but we're doing some gloss wash over some gloss varnish. Emando, thanks for the follow, brother. And we did this over our appreciated corn model. We did a tutorial on last week. And right now we're because it looks like it's all shiny and hideous. Right now we're just showing off how good the GW gloss wash is and how much better it is when you're trying to do a controlled wash. When you have, the cheesy poofs, thanks for the subs, dog. Oh my god, I love it. Thank you, player. So, the idea here is if you're trying to do controlled washes, which is a lot of my next level painting, the more broken up the surface tension is, Mike, the easier the wash will flow. And then we'll come back in with some of that Testers Model Masters Lustless, and we'll knock this motherfucker back down, and he'll look amazing. OG out of print. What year was this made, Ironheaded? What year were they selling this this juggernaut? It's the 90s? I know I had one of these when I was 17 or 18. Like 1999, I definitely had one of these in 1999. Whatever year, whatever that was. Okay. Getting that control wash. It is crucial to get that black line between the trim and the red. That is 99% of what we're doing. And we're getting a little bit more aggressive as we're getting comfortable with the model. You can see it. We're learning the how it flows. See, we got a little buildup down here. We're just going to wick it away. And since it's the gloss, it doesn't like distort the color at all. Yeah, guys, make sure to use the at Next Level Painting. If I don't see your question, don't worry. I try to break the show up with Q&A blocks along with painting blocks. It's very difficult for me with my ADHD to paint a model, talk, and read chat. I can paint and talk really well, but I cannot read the chat very well. That's why our show is a little bit different than the other blue streamers. We're gonna pause and do Q&As. But I do my best to look up at my tablet here and see if you guys are talking to me. But the chat's been moving so fast, I'm missing them, you know? But I will get to you in the Q&A section here in a second. We're almost there. So now we're coming in here, lining out this
tree. I say I'm 1,000,000%. That is better than 100%.
Orgasmic?
Mm.
1,000,000%?
1,000,000%!
Ooh, yeah!
Orgasmic is 1,000,000%, bro. He just earned himself 200 Yodog points. So I know somebody's going to be getting a gift bag this month. I love you, dog. Orgasmic with the top three best Twitch names I've ever heard. So you see, it's very difficult to look at directly in the light because how shiny it is, but you see what we're doing here.
Excellent!
Britain Zero, thanks for the follow, brother. And once we get all this wash laid down, I'm going to set it aside, let it dry. I'll matte varnish it.
How you like me now? Don't fuck this down. Ruthless, wow. Do you want to get the teeth knocked the fuck out? Want to get on it like that? Well, then shout.
My boy Angron checking in, saying he loves them corn juggernauts. Of course they please him. He earned himself some Yo Dogs, and he triggered the rarest GIF on the stream to trigger, the old dirty bastard Thug Life cat meme or GIF. Anyone who knows the stream? Jazar, man, I love you, brother. Boy, Jazar checking in, earning himself hundreds of Yo Dogs, saying congratulations. 1,000 followers. I love you, dog. All right, guys. So we're now up to the face and the top, these tops here. So these tops are going to be kind of easy. We're going to just go heavy with the wash. Let me get that centered on the camera. We're just going to kind of pour it on, let gravity do what it does. But I want to come back with the brown wash and do all the horns. Like I was saying, though, after the matte varnish dries and everything, I'll do some more details on this model. I'll make sure to Instagram that progress because I'm not going to be able to work on it next... it's risky. I might be able to work on it next stream if that's the case because I'm going to my tournament on my GT on Saturday, and I'm actually moving this guy. This is good. How many people are in the stream right now? 90? Whew! That's a lot of people. I feel nervous now. Orgasmic, you just missed the Trogdor gift. It got triggered in the sub just 5 minutes ago, brother. So here's the thing, guys. I'm going to be at a GT on Saturday filming some games. So I'm moving my stream to Friday. I already have it set to promote that it's on Friday on Facebook. So if you guys follow me on Facebook, you'll get the updates there. I will promote it on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. So don't forget that. I'm going to be doing 3:30. I'm going to be streaming right after Keyline Prime, another blue stream team member. We're trying to organize our schedules more so that way we have more painting content on more often. Got to get that black line in there. Sorry, guys. I'm going to cut myself off. There it is. So put a pin in it, guys. Going to be streaming on Friday, and I think I can risk it. I think I can hold off on some of the details if we want to until that Friday stream and say, yep, got a tournament tomorrow. Got to finish this model tonight. All right. And now let's just get this head done, and then we'll set him down and we'll talk. What is that? How men do? I want 1,000,000% more content. Doing my best, brother. We're getting closer and closer to our goals of being able to one day quit commissions and just do this full time. Taking requests, model of the week, giveaways. I mean, we're getting there. We're transitioning. You guys have been, you guys' support has been a gigantic part of that. Such a huge part of that. Can you imagine if we can stream like every day and do new models and new shit every day? So we're just getting this this wash around some of these details on his face, and then we'll put it down and let it dry. Sometimes you gotta get the right angle with this wash so it doesn't drain all weird. Like right now, it's trying to drain weird over here. Like I said, the good thing is you can play with the gloss wash. You got time to manipulate it. God, this guy is so old school, man. Can you believe how... I remember living in my parents' house, like still like a kid in high school, like building and playing with this model. And here's the other trick right here. Some of these bolts are built into the metal, into the red, but they don't have trim. Just drop a little ring around them so they have a nice little bit of definition there. Sorry for that angle. That angle sucks. All right, let me show off what we've done here. Hopefully it's not too hideous to behold because of all the gloss. All right. So, let's get him in focus. That's what we got, guys. Last week, we appreciated him with greens. We used some Vallejo shit. But the main red we used... let me see if I can track it down. Excuse me, guys. I'm going to have to cover the mic and cough here in a second. But I'm trying to find that red. All right, Header, where's that red at? Here it is. So, this is Bloody Red. A true blood red. Pre-shaded down. And he's looking great. I mean, he's looking like the 80s model that he probably is, you know? Love this. So let's set him down. Let him dry up. And then we'll work on the Berserker after some Q&A. I'll show you guys the Berserker again, too. And obviously, this Berserker, we already washed him. And we matte coated him, so he is ready to take some high extra highlights. And we're going to even airbrush this claw. And I got a secret tech today, guys. Something I've never done before. I was pleasantly surprised when I made this huge Vallejo order and got all these paints I've never even heard of in. I'm going to showcase three paints I've never used before by Vallejo. And we're going to use it on this guy's lightning claw today. First time ever. All right. One real quick. First off, excuse me, guys. Second off, cheers, guys. All right, Q&A time. First, actually, real quick, Jazar, love you, dog. Thank you for the donation. Angron, Orgasmic, Joe Darkblade coming in hot. You guys are doing work earning them yo dogs. And, spoiler alert, Saldok already redeemed 4,000 Yodogs, and he's getting an epic loot crate shipped to his house. All right, into Q&A right now. Real quick, Dumma. LOL, I can't take the Berserker seriously. No, you can't. It's old chaos. They're literally goofballs, dog. Like, they're so goofy. Um, Securius, shading Grey Knights as sympathy painting. Haspel should be happy. Oh, Haspel is happy. Shagath, is there any complementary color shading for yellow? Purple will work, bro. But grayscale will work, too. Like, you can definitely do grayscale pre-shading for yellow. For your, if you're going to write through your airbrush. Ironheaded, thank you for the calling the location of that paint out to my attention. I'm moving up backwards, guys, in the Q&A. Don't worry. Joe Darkblade says, looking sick, dog. Sick tech, you mean? Someone hit man with the sick tech. Yeah, ironheaded. A bigger brush. I was getting more ambitious than I was going on the model. You're right about that. Vag Slayer, top. He's in the top three most ridiculous Twitch names that I've seen. Totally inspiring shit. Sat here converting a Cord Lorne on a Skullcrusher Juggernaut, and have my out of print Bloodthirster, in Paint Stripper ready for the Demon Kit list. Hell yeah, brother! Gotta get that Demon Kit. You know what's up. Orgasmic, you know that the Chogdor gift does exist. Bobby Bootleg, I graduated high school in 95 and I bought Berserkers instead of an education. Worth it. Someone give that man a hashtag worth it. I'm scrolling up through the chat where you guys discovered you can use emotes now, and I can see 1 billion ICs. Grazer checking in said Sin and me told ourselves we would do it this summer, and then boom, Patreon confirmed. Oh, you guys are patrons now? Someone hype up Grazer. That's Grazer 6 over here. Someone ice this guy. Angron, thank you for the subscription. You know I love you, dude. Killing Time Painting says, I am thinking of starting a Zinch army, and I don't want to paint 1K Suns color scheme. They have like that red color, their pre-heresy colors. I love the pre-heresy colors. Take a look at them. Easton, you still checking in? You still watching, brother? That's one of my childhood friends right there. Mike Haspel, the Honorable Mike Haspel, checking out. Love you, dog. We're going to be doing a live webcast tomorrow night on Google Hangout. Check the internets for the links. Yep, now I have to scroll through like literally 3 pages of Yo Dogs and Ices to see anything. These emotes could have been a mistake. You guys are going to have to start giving me some ideas. Yeah, they are. Tie winning. They are really close to Blood Raven. The pre-heresy stuff. The pre-heresy Iron 1K Suns. Real quick. You guys, if you guys take a second to scroll down. Take a look at the new artwork for our next two emotes. Definitely willing to take suggestions on our next two, because when we get to 50 subscribers, we get a total of 6 emotes. And I think we get to sell t-shirts. So obviously, t-shirt ideas, emote ideas, guys. Oh, hold on a second, guys. I just sucked all the e-juice out of this. Phallic saved instrument. I'm gonna need a little bit more before I start.
Excellent.
We just got a new follow. Red Baron, what's up, player? Thanks for tuning in, man. If you're new to the stream, we got a lot going on. Check the info panels down below. Oh my god. Such a bitch. I have to use my tool. Oh, you know what it is? It's this stupid glove. No grip with a glove. I had it on Inside Out. I don't know if I can get behind a t-shirt with my face on it, Dumma. That might be too crazy. Iron-headed? Yeah, I can make it. Oh, sorry, that's a whisper. Yes. My sticker logo. Just my standard little hoodie skull guy. I was thinking of doing a keeping it icy shirt. A Doctor Who crying emote. Ah, still one more name. You know me too well. Always keep the tip clean like a stylized like airbrush and toothbrush. Oh, that's a good one. Face of Buddha with ancient Chinese technique. Oh, what if like we had a mountain and there's like a dude like walking up the mountain? Like just like a straight silhouette, like boom, you know what I mean? Like ancient Chinese technique. All right. Got a little bit of e-juice in there that'll keep me going. And we're going to jump in on this Berserker. What do you guys want to see me do first? You guys want to see me do a little bit of detail on this red? Do some highlights? Or do you guys want to see me pull out the airbrush? It's up to you. And while you guys are sorting that out, shout out once again to my new subscribers. Angron, the Cheesy Poofs, Gamma Goblins, Dumma, Apophis UK, Agent Arrow, Slow Fuse Gaming, Killing Tom Payton. Yo, thanks guys. And also to our donators who've earned themselves hundreds of Yo Dogs today to redeem for our epic prizes and swag crate. As Drazar, Angron, Orgasmic, I want to say Joe Darkblade. Is that how you pronounce that? And of course, Uncle Bang, his came in because he's doesn't have a debit card and he has to do e-checks every time. And let me trigger a little gift for Dumma because I think he donated and it didn't show up. So I'm actually personally really proud of this gift, so I'm going to trigger this gift. That's for you, Dumma. Love you, dog.
And his name is John C.
Darth Rob says airbrush. Green Agent Arrow says airbrush. A Jack Burton emote. Who the fuck said that? Less than mediocre, motherfucker. Iron Man, give that motherfucker 10 Yo Dogs. Write it down. Put it on the list. Jack Burton. I was literally in my kitchen this morning making a cup of coffee, and the theme song at the beginning of that movie, Big Trouble in Little China, like do 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 do, and he's like, "This is no Jack Burton under pork chop." And I was like in my head on loop this morning while I was drinking my coffee. Dog. Psh. We get definitely. You gotta pay your dues. You know what I'm saying? It's like I told my ex-wife. Checks in the mail. Alright, we're gonna pull out the airbrush, guys. Lightning claws it is. Oh, Killing Time Payton, that's a great idea. Literal best of hitting you up on a literal best of all days. Of all tees. Oh, hitting you up with the literal best of all tees. Hail to the king, baby. Ash, that's a good one too, Absinthe. You guys throwing out some sick ones. Yep, we're definitely guys too, Dumma. Alright, guys. Let's go to airbrushing. If you guys don't mind, do me a solid. Don't forget to share this channel link on your respective 40K groups you're a part of on Facebook and your Twitters. Let's get the maximum hobby love possible, man. I really appreciate you guys helping me promote. Yep. Ironhead, it's pretty much going to have to be a Jack Burton gift. This shirt is my paint rag. That's a good one. All right, guys. Moving all this bullshit out of the way. Because we got to do something first before we pull out the airbrush. So I'm going to show you guys another ancient Chinese technique. Right here. So what we got here is, all intents and purposes, that's the tip. That's just the tip, okay? Jazar, we gave everybody a loot crate just now when you were gone. I'm sorry. Okay. The fuck is my shit? Oh my god, where's my airbrush cleaning setup? There it is. So much bullshit. Alright guys, so here's the ancient Chinese technique. This is suspended in a tiny amount of pure airbrush cleaner from Vallejo. Just this part. The rest of my airbrush is in a much more diluted solution. Popeye's chicken is the shiznit. Another good one. And it's because I've been running a lot of primer through it, and I also just ran the gloss varnish through it. So I knew it was going to require a little bit of special love. So we're definitely... This is definitely something I recommend anytime you're running, like, surface primers and gloss varnishes and bullshit through your brush. Alright. And the next part of this cleaning technique here is, I like to get the needle out of the airbrush. And I like to do a little dry fitting right here. And that's because I can kind of see if it's pushing any paint up. If I can see any discoloration up there. Oh, let me get that in focus. So I'm seeing if it's pushing out any paint. And it is. You see there's a little bit of specks right there. You see that? We just dislodged all that paint. So I'm just moving it around. Making sure we've broken all that bullshit up. Alright. Our airbrush is sitting in the shot glass.
Excellent!
Thanks for the follow. Die Bolt, I think is what that was. Grazer knows what's up. Let's put it back together. Hand tighten this thing. Get a good grip on it. All right, let's get the compressor going. All right. Compressor's charging up. I'm going to run a little air through this as soon as it's ready to go. A little air plus a little water. The Bolt. Thanks, man. Been a long time lurker. P.S. It's pronounced T-Bow? 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 Is it T-Bow? T-Bow. Got it.
Excellent! Excellent!
Dumbo, did you literally just follow? For the first time? Sprat, thanks for the follow, homie. Bo, Tebow. I don't know how to read good. Alright. So, we got our, if you look up here. I'm just gonna run some water through the airbrush in our hobo cleaning sink down here. Just making sure to get some of that solvent out of the airbrush. Just running some, cleaning it through. Just gonna run it until it's done.
Excellent.
Securious, thanks for the follow. Love you, dog. Doing a little backflow technique. All right. Okay, guys, you guys ready for it? Worldwide debut of some of my new favorite greens. Okay. Setting down the airbrush. I'm gonna show you guys first green. I never used this green. Oh, and I just spilled all my solvent. That was awesome. This green is showing up a lot more blue than it really is on camera here. Probably because of the white balance. Yeah, it's like, okay, let me put it this way, guys. That shit is blue. Let me see if I can fix that. Hold on. Let's see if I can manipulate. Oh, god damn it. I can't manipulate the white balance right now. Let me try something. Let me switch scenes. Let me see if we can get a little bit of focus here. Are we gonna, come on camera. Now, is this still just blue as shit? Okay, that's some old bullshit right there. I'm not happy with that. Okay, I promise you this shit is green with blue in it. It is very similar to hot turquoise, but it's definitely not that fucking blue as it's showing up with the lighting. Okay, guys, we're gonna do something. We're gonna do some ancient shit right here. You guys ready for the gangster gumbo? Okay. Little brush flow, flow improver, little airbrush. God. Tongue twister, homie. Airbrush flow improver. This is called scurvy green absinthe. Pour some in. Stir it up. Little bit of water. Backflow. Gangster gumbo engaged. Make sure we got good flow over here off camera. Yep, we're good. Let's get a glove on. Because we're about to go raw dog. So We're going to do something crazy here. We're going to airbrush. Shit. I'm going to get my focus switch back over, guys. Operating two cameras. Okay, so I'm going to apply this over black because I want that heavy contrast. And I want that fade. So we're just going to hold the guy like super crazy. And just start airbrushing some of this into the tips right here. Just like that. Let's get the angle right on this side so we don't get any on his armor. Get some on the inside of the blade. Oh, gotta be careful. We just got some on his helmet.
Excellent.
Residue from our finger. Let's clean that up real quick. And actually, it's gonna fit right in there and look kind of like oxidation. So we got a lot on my. I got some on my finger right now, and I just tracked it on him. Let me get the angle right. And also, before I accidentally spray on the juggernaut, let's move the juggernaut. Tumma, did you just subscribe to my channel or follow my channel for the first time? We're making sure just to get some built up right there. We want that black to still show through. I'm blowing pure air on it right now. And now I'm just adding a little bit more to reinforce the color. Just like that. And we're gonna put some on his fingers too. Since he's got the combo Freddy Krueger hand and the Wolverine claws, want to give all that love to that hand. It's all about holding the angle right. See, I'm gonna spray it under his hand right here. Gonna hold it upside down a little bit. Just getting it on the tips. That's just the tip. So it's coming out so blue on camera. I'm not happy with that. It's got so much more green than this. All right. Well, that's still the foundation of this effect we're working. So we got the scurvy green down. And like I said, it looks straight fucking blue on camera. That's stupid. I hate that. We're going to dump out our pot, and we're going to switch it up to jade green. Clean out some of this color in our airbrush. Hopefully jade green doesn't look blue on camera. That'll be super upsetting. And you guys have seen the Gangster Gumbo, so I'm just going to go real quick over here. The thing, though, is you got to shake these paints like crazy. Ugh. So, like I said, I just added a bunch of Vallejos to my cart, and I was like, I've never had these colors. Let's see how they look. And yo, Scurvy Green and Jade Green, they're fucking awesome. So I'm just making a quick little gangster gumbo with Jade Green. Off camera while you guys look at what we've done so far. Okay, it's a little thin. It might be too thin. We'll see. Oop. I just brightened it up big time, didn't I? Might be too bright. Took my filter off to see if that would help. Now, I can definitely see that our white balance is a little blue right now. All right, best we're going to do. Oh, we're getting speckling. You guys know about that. Got it. What did we do when we got speckling? First thing we do is find the toothbrush that I felt I dropped on the floor earlier. Clean the tip all day. All right. Oh, we got a little clog in here. I just cleaned this motherfucker. Okay, we're looking good. So we're going to come in with that jade green and really just make it pop. Yeah, look at that, how jade green looks straight blue. It's not even remotely green. Okay, that's... Okay, you guys are seeing that's straight blue, right? Okay, one second, guys. Let me see if I can't fix this. I don't know. I really... God damn it. I just don't know what to do. Is it getting a little green now? God. There's so much... It's like very aqua green here. You know, it's so funny. It's because we have a green and red, and the temperatures, like for lighting purposes, like they're opposite sides of like light temperature. And so like it's almost like, since I don't have a professional lighting setup, it's like I think I'm supposed to have, in this situation, a gold bounce to bounce gold light on it. Yeah, this right here, I'm going to switch this out for a black mat here soon. All right. Okay, let's get that tightness. Now we're just going to get these fingertips real quick. Just super easy. You see that? Just like that. Oh, now we got to get the front. So I'm going to put my thumb here to block his body. We're going to block it out, and we're going to try to drop some of this green in the front of these claws. And of course, this is not normal for me. I promise this never happens. Got a little clog there. And we're just trying to add some of this green to the tips of his fingers. Must have been from that gloss, the gloss varnish I used earlier. Must be just dislodging itself in there. And it's definitely speckling. You guys know what to do. You just stop airbrushing when that happens. And you clean the airbrush out. And I don't like, I think it looks worse without the filter. So we're going to do the filter. Yep, filter's better. Alright, so what I'm going to do, guys, real quick, is I'm just going to run some water through the airbrush. Because we definitely have a little bit of dislodged varnish in here. And we're going to take our toothbrush, we're going to dip into our solvent, and we're going to put a little and run it through. Scrub the tip down. Alright. I'm feeling good about that. Take the glove off. The glove is dead to us. It's covered in bullshit right now. Okay, so I'm going to pull out the next green. And that's foul green. Right here. And this one, it takes a good shaking. Flow improver. Green. Water. Stir it up a little bit. Let's gumbo. Woo! Didn't have the needle in there. Yeah, iron headed. No, we had it all in solvent after the varnish. It's just that it must have not been good enough. That's why we had the tip and extra concentrate too. All right, we got something going here. Worm sign. All right. Let's drop some of this foul green off on the tip. Give it that nice, nice shine. Just like that. Tops of these Freddy Krueger fingers. Like that. Put our thumb right here. And we're going to just spritz the tops of his hand so it doesn't get on his body.
And his name is John C.
Jazar coming in hot. I think he just earned himself 200 Yo Dogs. Jazar is making a play. Jazar is making a play for the loot crate. Love you, Jazar. All right. So that's what we got so far. Now, here's the final trick right here. We got some of this foul green in here still. We're going to take some white, and we're going to pour a little bit of white in that joint. A couple drops. And once I do this, I'll go back to the Q&A and I'll talk to you guys. Jazar, I love you, homie. Okay, a couple drops of white. Stir it up. And this is going to lighten up big time. Flow improver. It's probably going to need more water. Anytime you put white in there, you can assume it's going to try to speckle on you. So already get your toothbrush. Get that tip clean. This feels dirty now for some reason. You guys ruined this for me. Okay. Okay. A little of that white mixed in. Let's get the tip. There it is, getting that nice shine. Flip it over. We gotta clean the tip, we got some speckles already. Put your thumb down right here. Let's get the tops of these Wolverine claws right there. Is that my man Killing Time Payton? You know what? Now that I look at it in real life, it's pretty fucking blue. I thought this was going to be so much greener than it is. Like, I'm looking at it, I'm like, you know, it's fucking blue, guys. I might have thrown a fit for no reason. It's so blue. What I'm doing now is I'm cleaning the airbrush out just a little bit because I'm going to drop a little bit more white off on the very tips. So I'm just using the hobo sink at our feet. Real quick, let me recite this real quick. So Killing Time says, I can't let Jazar beat me to that loot crate. Jazar said, make a keep the tip clean shirt, exclamation point. So, guys out of control.
And his name is John C.
Gamma Goblin checking in, saying that the blue looks fresh. You know what? I'm happy with the blue. You're right. So real quick, one last time, guys. And this is why proper airbrushing takes long. Getting those those true transitions. A lot of people would have gone right to black to the highest contrast, and that's how you ruin it. So you see how long we've been working on this. Now, obviously, we're getting a smoother effect than I could ever paintbrush. You know, some people might be able to paintbrush that smooth, but that's why we use the airbrush. Get that white in there. I already know from experience. All right, this might work because we only need a little bit. All right. So the trick here is just to put an exclamation point, on this custom claw. So we're getting in tight. This is 99% air, 1% water, or paint. And we're just dragging a pure white tip in there. Same thing for the Freddy Krueger claw. Freddy Krueger. See that? Flip it over. Looks like we got a little... We might have to touch this up because it looks like we got a bullshit-ass little fuzzy on the claw. Right here. Okay, we got it. But not before we scrape some fucking paint off of it. Scary Terry. I love Scary Terry. Alright, we're gonna have to touch that up. Get our thumb right here. Let's clip these claws. Get the tip of them. Oh, there it is. So that's what we got right there. Let me set that down for you guys to look at. There it is. Boom. Let me, this might help with contrast. Sit the fuck down on this glove already, Scary Terry. There it is. Yes, contrast, much improved. Yeah, we're definitely switching to a black construction paper workspace here soon. That's so much better. All right, guys, I'm about to jump back in the Q&A as soon as I run some water through this airbrush. And that was frustrating. That was a frustrating moment right there. I'm about to have a diva breakdown right there over that bullshit. Airbrushing is my shit, you know? Alright. Ran a little bit of cleaner through the airbrush. Oh, Scary Terry would be a good emote. God, we got so many. We're going to have to come up with an emote fan page here soon so that we can make sure that as a community together, this is serious. Like, these emotes belong to both of us. So... I feel like you guys are possibly more important in the decision-making process than me. So I definitely would like to see a list of submissions come through on Facebook here or on the Brush Lickers page. Somebody would set up a little post for me. Maybe Ironhead will get on that at some point. All right. Back to the chat. It's 10 minutes. Ironheaded, what's our peak? If we get it 100 subscribers, or sorry, that's not the right number, obviously. 100 viewers, what should we do? What should we do? Damn it, where the hell did... God damn. I'm literally... Okay, are you guys as bad as this as I am? I pick something up, put it down, it just vanishes to the warp every fucking time. Alright, I'm going back to the chat. Pixel Ninja 88, that mini is looking sick. Love it. Scary Terry should be the next emote. Ty winning. Yeah, I'll feel you on that. Drazar. What do you call the Lightning Fist Power Combo? Oh, that's definitely the Wombo Combo. Slow Fuse. Thanks, brother. I watched you do that same trick last week, and that's how I figured out how to do it. Excellent! Sifa Wall, thanks for the follow. Phil Helmsley, thanks for the follow. Gamma Goblins, earning 200 Yo Dogs with a $10 donation. Killing Tom Payton, 240 Yo Dogs with a $12 donation. Beating Drezar's little bitch ass down. Apparently they're having a little war. And just so you guys know, I have literally infinity loot crates, so. Because I just take the money you guys give me and just fucking go buy the stuff. You know what I'm saying? Roxon, just got back to the desk after an airbrush session. What have you been working on? We are working on an out-of-print corn juggernaut lord. I think he was like a champion of chaos, is what that shit was back in the day. This is what we've been working on. Let me see if we can get this guy to look a little bit better. There we go. See, that guy's doing. Look, that's looking a lot better. I'm just going through the Q&A, guys, looking for the Atlex level paintings before I come back down. Tebow says it looks awesome. You're right. It's now that I see it, it's actually super fucking blue. There's literally almost no green in it now that it's all done. Isn't that crazy? It is so green in the bottle. Maybe I'm colorblind. Ty Winning, Dune reference for the win. Duncan Idaho approves. Of course he does. Patrick Stewart will always approve. I know a lot of people were talking about airbrushes, and I think probably my people came through on that one. D. Craddiesburg, we like using the Awada Eclipse here. Patriot's not a bad airbrush. Grex makes a good airbrush. They all make a good airbrush. It's just for miniature paintings. I really like the Awada Eclipse the most right now. Dumma, you missed some shit, dog. Back down. Can you, D. Craddiesburg says, can you appreciate it with a paintbrush? Yeah, the masters used to, man. That's how I used to paint portraits. Definitely. You can paint, like, I mean, you can definitely, like, you can basically prime a model black, then, like, grab some gray spray paint, and then, like, hit it with some gray right over the top. So he's, like, black, and he's, like, you know, Zenthiel gray with a spray paint, and literally, you know, or, you know, you and then maybe a little spurts of white with it, all with spray paint. And then you can go in with, like, watered-down red, and you can get it to stick really easy. Angron asks if I stole this off of eBay. No. This was donated to me by an individual whose name escapes me right now because I'm not bad with names, I promise. It's just that so many people have so many different names and so many platforms. Donated me via the Spiky Bitsabi group. And then it was converted to have that cool lightning claw by Brian Mole. And this is my Crimson Slaughter Corn Lord with a Lightning Claw Power Fist, with the Demon Heart and Sigil on a Juggernaut. It's like 205 points. He has a 2-up save, it will not die, 4-up invulnerable, and with all my combos in my Chaos Army, by the time I get into close combat, he's gonna have a 3-up invulnerable, Eternal Warrior, and 4-up Funeral Pain for my Psychic Powers. So he's stronger than a Chapter Master. Like that's one of my ancient Chinese secrets. Some guy with a Chapter Master Shield Eternal is going to roll up against me, thinks he's got this, and then all of a sudden, he's like, wait a minute, you're Eternal Warrior, you have It Will Not Die, and a Fort Field of Pain? What the fuck? So, and 7 attacks on the charge. Wolf Sark, is the Lightning Claw Power Fist combo better than the Axe of Korn Power Fist combo? That's Korn Demon Kid. That's different, man. That's like all. with Khorne Demon Kid, remember, like, if you take the blood armor, you can't take any other relic. That's it. So, absolutely, you take the blood armor and Demon Kid and Lightning Claw Power Fist. Because you're going to have a lot of opportunities to use that Power Fist of Rage and Furious Charge from the Blood Tithing. So, if you need it. But I like this guy better. Because with my psychic powers and the Cyclopia Cabal, I'm always going to have Eternal Warrior and Four Funeral Pin. For Gen Z, how are you going to deliver him? Well, that you ask, he is going to be... This is breaking news. No one even knows about this. He's going to be in a unit of Crimson Slaughter, Khorne Spawn, with Crimson Slaughter, Sorcerer, with the Bale Star and a Jump Pack, level 3, obviously all the spell familiars, Cyclopean Cabal attached, and that way now they can use the new GWFAQ to where they have one Jump Pack guy in there who can let them reroll the charge if he doesn't use his Jump Pack. He can also roll for Divination to get Sanctuary, Forewarning, which I'm going to combo off of Sanctuary from Sanctic, and then get some Endurance. And they're going to run across the table. Literally, you know, the whole unit's going to have 3 up invulnerables, 4 funeral pain, and it's Spawn. People never see that shit coming. The Axe of Khorne is not an artifact. The Axe of Khorne is cool. You know what I'm saying? Like, I know what you're saying. It's just... with the Khorne Demon Kin, I would probably just do a Power Fist. I wouldn't even fucking worry about it. Pixel Ninja says, do you have any videos you play in 40K? Yeah. If you haven't heard of The Long War, check out thelongwar.net. Got tons of them. I edit those battle reports every week. D. Kratesberg. Yeah, we're going to do more ADOS. We're going to get on the tree people. We're going to paint a beetle lady here real soon, bro. Jazar, you got to see some. You want to? I'll definitely take some pictures this weekend with the whole army. It's not that it's okay. Like, I got all my OG green pay jobs. They're like, I mean, they look great, but like, that's like 4 years ago tech. Like, so the army is not going to look as good as like the new shit I've been pumping out, because I've been basically collecting this Chaos army for 8 years. So it's got some old ass paint jobs in it, man. But I'm going to film all the games this weekend, guerrilla style, and we'll definitely Instagram some pictures from the Hammer Rat GT. D. Kratesberg? All right. If we can get where are we at? We got over an hour left. We got more time. So, if we can get 100 viewers tonight, we'll definitely do a Yo Dog giveaway. Terry Scary and Snowball. Snowball, because my fur is white and pretty. All right, so we're going to do a little bit of detail on this Khorne Berserker since we were working on that Lightning Claw. I kind of want to go right into that Lightning Claw with a paintbrush now. Show you guys some shit right here. All right. Shit's getting crowded over here, desk. Stop being crowded. All right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull out some pure white. And I'm going to just start doing some tight edge highlighting on this Lightning Claw. Got my palette over here off to the side. Put down a little bit of white on it. Pour in a little bit of water. Yep, Easton knows. James Westfall and Dr. Kenneth Noisewater. Great name. One of my favorite movies of all time. Okay. So, I'm just getting some white put together on my detail brush. And I'm going to do my best here on stream because I am notoriously bad at detailing on stream. All right. So what I'm going to do here, see if this is on frame. I'm gonna drop some edge highlights off on this blade to create that metallic, that like real, that gleam. Just like that. You want to just get it up over that black because that's what really gives it that shine. Sorry, I gotta flip it upside down to get the other lightning claw, sorry. It's about getting positioned. Getting that shit on lock. Yep. Now I'm doing it, painting on my hand because I forgot to put my glove on. Getting that gleam. See that contrast? Get that lightning claw tech on lock. Super easy. And the trick is to make sure to pull that white up over the black. That's really what nails it. Drives it home. Now we're going to bring some down on the bottom. That's a little aggressive. I might have fucked this up a little bit. All right. Let's connect the two right here. Add a little bit of extra white right there. There it is. So now we got a nice, just baller looking, like just, it's just gleaming, you know? Scary Terry approves. Just getting some paint on my palette ready. Okay, now we gotta get his Freddy Krueger hand. Should I get that gleam looking fresh? And you see how easy that is? Like, once you get the airbrush figured out. Jazar. All right, Grazer, we love you, bro. Take it easy, homie. Grazer just came in with a 100 Yo Dog donation. Scary Terry looks dope. Scary Terry does look dope. Scary Terry is very happy with his claw. Easton, if you're talking to me, use at Next Level Painting. It's easier. Easton, you're out of here, bro. Love you, homie. I grew up with that guy. Okay, let's get the back side of this Freddy Krueger claw. There it is. You see that? Got that extra gleam right there. And that's like, that's how you combo off with the airbrush. Like, that's the problem is like, you know, I'm definitely one of the biggest advocates for airbrushing that there is, obviously. Like, anybody who knows who I am knows that, like, airbrush all day, every day. Like, stop making this hobby hard on yourself. Like, but don't stop there. Like, you got to challenge yourself. You can save so much time with an airbrush. Like, a lot of people would have airbrushed that and would have been like, that's it. That's the dopest fade. That's the dopest lightning claw I've painted in my entire life. But it's like, yeah, but, like, for five more minutes, look at this. Now you got that shit that you see in the magazines. Like, now that's that shit you see on Golden Demon's displays. Like, when they do their lightning claws. Like, you're like, oh, shit. I just got the freshest, most smooth transition fade with my airbrush. And then with a little bit of tracing, a.k.a. edge highlighting, my claw is just, like, unquestionable. You know? That's the power of airbrushing and not being lazy afterwards. People think that everything I do is airbrushing all day. I was like, yeah, I airbrush for 5 minutes, man, in the grand scheme of things. I mean, I'll do like a big airbrush day in the week, but then it's all paintbrushing after that. All right, we got a little bit more highlighting to do on it, though. He's got a few more fingers. Scary Terry. Yeah, you know what? Furry blue. That definitely, like, that's what my channel's about. It's about showing you how to use airbrushes. Because, like, mechanically speaking, like, anyone, pretty much everyone's got it figured out. The problem is like, how the fuck do you actually use that piece of shit? You know what I mean? Well said, Slow Fuse Gaming. All right, now we're going to sneak in another highlight on top of this finger. I wonder if you can see that. It's hard to see.
Excellent!
I'm going to drop a couple of highlights right here. Maybe you can see that. See that? Oh, God, it's so hard. One of these highlights got a little thick on me. So that means the whole line needs to get thicker. It's literally... on. There it is. Just dropping a couple of blings up on these knuckles. Get some of that electric. There it is. Coming in so hot. Yeah, Dumba. This is definitely the most ill scary Terry there is. All right, now we're gonna flip it over so we can get underneath some of these Freddy Krueger hands, fingers. And let's see what we can't do. 1 second, guys. Shout that out. Laser for eyes. Thanks for the follow. 79 viewers. What the hell happened to all our people? They don't like Scary Terry as much as we do. I know it's late on the East Coast. So we're not going to get to the 100 people giveaway tonight. Ironheaded, what was our record tonight? Dumbo, who Snowball? Snowball the Juggernaut? Alright, so, sorry guys for not talking. I'm like literally holding my breath doing this shit. This is like, you will be rewarded for literally being as patient and methodical and focused as possible when you're doing this kind of shit. Like, don't fuck around. Don't get lazy now. Right? Like, isn't that some, like, confrontation miniature shit you used to see back in the day? Like, how the fuck? I'm still dry brushing. I don't know how to do that. And now you're like, wait, those motherfuckers had airbrushes. We got the 97. Ah, oh, damn it. Agent Arrow, hashtag worth it. Love you. Pixel Ninja, where's my accent from? Do I have an accent, guys? You know, when I moved to, I grew up in Miami. I lived there for 21 years. When I moved to Colorado, aka White People USA, everyone said I had an accent. I was like, what? I guess that's my accent. My accent is South Miami. South Miami white person. Jazar, love you, dog. Take it easy, brother. Yo, Papa Smurf, right? Those confrontation models made me throw my models away. That's like, you know what I'm saying? I'm like, look at how awesome this fucking Ultramarine captain is. And then you open up and see one of these fucking confrontation miniatures in a magazine. You're like, fuck this captain. God damn it, I suck at painting. Mood Honey checking in. Greatest, one of the greatest, greatest friends I've ever made in my life. Really, Karn? They, Rackham, they really, oh my god, they didn't use airbrushes? God, insane people. Yeah, poor bastards. Alright. So, what we have to do is we have to flip this motherfucker over in this weird ass angle. Let's see if I can get it on camera. That's the hard part about doing something like this, with this detail work. Trying to get you that, like, the freshest camera angles. I'm gonna try to sneak in some highlighting right here. There it is. It's looking dope. Thanks for making me do that work, guys. I really appreciate it. I was like, oh, please just let me do some red highlights. You guys are like, no, paint that lightning claw, lazy fucker. Let me set him down for a second. I'm going to have to take a smoke break and talk to you guys. Because that was hard. That was challenging. All right, there he is. He's in focus. Oh, God. God. Hey, guys. I missed you. All right. Oh, yeah. And here's, I guess this is it confirmation? This one is Snowball? Steve, look at this. Oh, Steve, did you just get in the stream, Steve? Motherfucking out of print Juggernaut Lord, bro, with Lightning Claw Power Fist for my fucking Crimson Slaughter Army. Tell me you're not jealous. Tell me you're not fucking jealous. Uncle Bang. What's up, brother? First off, Uncle Bang, your donation from last week came through in an e-check because you don't know how debit cards work. Came through 13 hours ago. Thank you, dog. And you missed us painting this lightning claw so far. And we did a little bit of wash tech on the Juggernaut. And now I'm taking a quick celebratory drink and I'm going to smoke a little bit. The delay is nothing, man. It doesn't mean anything to me, brother. I'm just teasing you. Your donations changed my life. Tebow, I'm in Colorado Springs. Where were you when you lived here? I lived in Woodland Park, just west of Colorado Springs. I used to go to Colorado Springs all the time. Get drunk on Tejon Street daily. Ironheaded. My slang? That's Miami slang? Sound like I'm from Brooklyn? Says Pixel Ninja. Never been to New York. That's where Michal is. I'm definitely gonna have to fly to him at some point. We're gonna definitely have to do a Breastlickers con. Yep, so officially Dumma named the Juggernaut is named Snowball. The writer is Scary Terry. And no, the Juggernaut is not done. He has highlighting still to be done. He's got to get... Real quick, guys. Let me show you guys. So, all this highlighting we just did... Kane's Stabe? Kane Eats Stabe? God, how the fuck do you say that? Thank you for the host, my man. One second, guys. Thank you, brother. Truly appreciate that. Welcome to the stream. Let me show you guys what I was going to show you. Okay, so this line to call, everything we did here, you see, all we did here was airbrush the transition in and then edge it, right? Well, what did we do here? Like, that's literally the same thing. These big blocks on the shoulders here. Make sure we're focused. This big square shoulder, that's the same shit. So you know I'm going to come in here and I'm going to highlight this shit up, dog. I'm going to come in and it's just going to be gleaming when we're done. And I have a color in mind I want to try. I got this in from my Vallejo order. I got this hot orange. And this hot orange is really close to the blood red we use. It's just a little bit brighter, you see? So I think that's a real great highlight to drop on those edges. So that's basically what's going to have to happen to Snowball here. Scary Terry is definitely not going to be the only one with fresh highlights in this duo. Ironheaded. Am I Snowball and you're Scary Terry? Let me move this fat juggernaut out of the way. There it is. All right, back to the Q&A smoke break session. Ty Winning. When you issue a challenge with him, you gotta yell, "You're gonna die." Yep, I know what you're saying, bitch. You're gonna die, bitch. Scary Terry. I love Rick and Morty, if you guys don't know.
I say I'm 1,000,000%. That is better than 100%.
1,000,000%?
1,000,000%!
Booyah!
That's my boy, Still Warmer Name, coming in. Catching up on my Yo Dogs. That man just won a shit pile of Yo Dogs, Ironhead. Love you, homie. it's not Juggernaut, it's Snowball.
Excellent!
Uncle Bang, you got your very first airbrush compressor kit the other day and excited to try out your first Gangsta Gumbo. Yo, can we please hype up Uncle Bang? Let's ice this fool. You can flex on him if you need to. Right now I'm looking for my brush soap because my detail brush has a bunch of white on it. And I can't find it. So I'm just got to use a little airbrush cleaner. Where the fuck is my airbrush cleaner? God damn it, I'm awful at little things. I literally can't keep track of little things. Tebow, Tejon is covered in Pokemon players. Dog, I used to get so drunk there. Last time I was there, me and Rob Bear were there. He came out. We got drunk as shit at the mansion.
Excellent!
Chickens 4411 has followed. Thank you for the follow, brother. Refractor Ross, thank you for the follow. All right. Oh, yep. I'm scrolling down to get caught up, and I just seen a billion ices and flexes. And next week, hopefully, or next week, next, what is it, Friday, this Friday, like literally in a few days, I'm going to put in the, as soon as we're done streaming, first thing, first order of business, submit the new emotes. Because it takes like a day to get your signature, your tag approved, and then another like 2 days to get the imagery. So there's a chance we still won't have them on Friday. That's why I'm going to submit the thing ones we've got right now. Tebow, you think you got an STD at the mansion? If you did, sorry, brother. It's my fault. Word, word. Okay, guys. As I'm sitting here relaxing, I've had two stiff iced teas. Perfectly willing to have a third with you guys. Perfectly willing. We got 1,000 followers now. Last week was our most successful stream yet, over 100 people. Brush Liquors United is taking off. Anyone who doesn't know what Brush Liquors United is, if you look at the top of the window, you'll see that there is a next level painting, Being Creative, on Brush Liquors United, link there. Definitely, you're going to want to check the Brush Liquors United stream team because it's got multiple powerful stream channels there. Slow Fuse, Meechow, Electric Eve, Grendler, Guide Misa, Dirty Burger, you know, Keylon Prime, you know, Geekin Nation, or Geek of Spades. We got mad people in there painting all the time, so it's a powerful resource tool to get your 40K painting fix on. We also got a Facebook page. Check out all the shit down below. Damn it, we don't have a blue command yet. Ironheaded, what the fuck are you good for? But you can see down below. Actually, it's on timer. Don't worry. It's on timer circulating, so we got something. Try exclamation point brush liquors. Try that one. But we got all the links down below. You know, take a look at the panels. There's a lot going on this channel. You know, we got the rewards for the raffle. Excellent. We're doing one-on-one painting tutorials. We're raffling that away. We're doing every month, one-on-one over Skype or Google Hangout or whatever, Discord, and we'll work together for an hour. So we're raffling away. Those are worth 250 Yodogs. We're doing an epic swag crate worth $100 MSRP, and we're doing a gift bag just to say thank you. Everyone in the stream is earning Yodogs, our digital currency, right now. And you can check how much currency you have by using the exclamation point Yodog command. It'll bring up how many you have. Check out the game. We're doing a lot right now. Yori... Dog, we still got almost an hour, brother. Don't fucking worry, homie. We got more to come, son. Poor Yori was about to fucking have a little heart attack. Roxin one, you spelled yo dog like a stupid person. You gotta spell it right. And obviously, familiarize yourself with the channel, guys. Okay, next up. Are we going to highlight this red dial? Because that's... Okay, I'm going to give you guys... We could probably do both, man. Ain't no reason we can't do both. We'll highlight this red. We're going to experiment with the new orange color and try to highlight up this Berserker Lord. Yori, he says, LOL, I was D&D, just got done, and thought I would catch some stream action with y'all. All day, brother. All day, or day. Tama, pinnacle of the English language. Yeah, motherfucker? I know how to speak goodly. I use my words. I speak pretty. Me speak pretty one day. Yes, T-Bell. Micho is the literal shit. He's awesome. He's one of the best painters I've ever seen. All right, back to business. Okay, so we're going to experiment with the new hot orange, new to me, maybe not to you guys. I make big random Christmas presents to myself with Vallejo paints. I'll just go through and say, I haven't used any of these paints. We're going to buy every single fucking one of them. That's how responsible I am with you guys' donations. And then I use them on the stream. Okay, Scary Terry on deck, rolling up the old sleeves, getting fat, I need a bigger shirt. Alright, so here's a new color, hot orange. There's my painting palette back there, and we're gonna give this motherfucker an epic shake. Ancient Chinese technique, I hold it upside down when I shake it, forcing the pigment back to the top. While our little Chinese water bottle lids out of the way. Put down some right here. And let's, already knowing that this is a new color, I can't commit myself to just going so raw dog that I go in without a little bit of the blood red. Now this is the color that we use to paint this guy. He's entirely composed of this color with a pre-shade. So I'm going to use that to pull from. Just in case. Comet Bus. Oh shit, was that a David Sedaris reference? I don't know what the fuck that is. What did I say that made that seem like I had a reference? Because if I'm accidentally copying somebody else's catchphrases, I need to know right now. Alright, let's get down to business, guys. Vagrant Wolf. Oh my god! Vagrant Wolf, we're a partner now. We've got emotes. Everybody, hype this motherfucker up. Ice Vagrant Wolf right now. Show him. Vagrant Wolf is the guy who got me into Twitch. That's my boy, Saudi. That's my boy right there. He spent 3 hours on a Skype call with me, showing me how to use all the software. Flex on him. Show him some muscles, guys. Alright, what I'm doing right now is I'm mixing in a healthy amount of this new orange color in with a little bit of this blood to have the common link between the two before I go beast mode. And we're about to take a big risk right now. We have no idea what's going to look like right now. All right, that's not bad. Getting that first line in on this power fist. It's all right. All right. All right. I'm with it. I'm picking up what you're putting down, Scary Terry. There it is. I'm with that. Ironheaded with the flex kapow. Tell me you're going to tag me on Facebook? Please. All right, so I'm feeling more ambitious now that we laid it down. I'm going to grab a little bit of the new orange without any of the red in it. And we're going to come back in and do a little bit more. See what it looks like. Oh, yeah, that's good. That's subtle and that's strong. I like that. Lasers for eyes. That's surgical care level highlighting. I just run a blender pencil soaked in paint. Props to your skills. Still one more name. Look at the emotes. Click on the little smiley face bottom right, and it should show you at the very top the new ones. All right, so now we're gonna move along. Now that we highlighted that little section, oh look, we can carry the highlight through. Let's make sure we're in autofocus or focus mode, and we're gonna carry this little highlight down. All right, cool, cool, cool. Let's move over to Scary Terry's Lightning Claw delivery system here, whatever this is. I don't think anybody else is having that problem, Ironheaded. Maybe he's on mobile. Maybe the chat thing is lagging behind. At the very least, you can use the explanation point flex and icy for right now. Vagrant. Hell yeah, bro. You need to get back on stream, brother. Painting some fucking space wolves. Just dropping a couple little... downloading a few. See, now this area is a little darker, so you definitely want to add a little bit more blood red to the mix versus that orange, so it's not so sudden. We're just dropping extreme highlights off is all we're doing here. We're not like blending anything. We're just dropping some edge highlights. Like for example, I'm gonna do his face real quick. Let me see if I can get under the camera here. Oh, let me extend the light real quick. All right, Scary Terry. Let's do it. So what we're going to do here is we're going to just... Okay, his face is really dark, so we're going to grab a little bit more blood red to our mix, like I was saying. Just gonna give him a nice little eyebrow. That simple. We're gonna drop down to his cheeks. Like so. Hold my breath. Almost passed out. Almost fainted. Okay, so what we're going to do here is... still in focus. We're going to come in on his, like, chin down here. Scary Terry's chin. And the little gum area above his teeth. Like that. Scary Terry in the house. Scary Terry, bitch. One of my favorite Rick and Morty episodes. Let's, underneath this old Scary Terry's lightning claw hand. Here we go. Not the easiest. Give him a nice little highlight right there. Yori, you want to see my painting station layout? Dog, it's a disaster in here, man. I'll show you guys at the end of the stream. Do a little 360. My office is only 10 by 10 now. I live in Hollywood now, so I'm literally spending, like, all my fucking money on this place for the just extra 10 by 10 fucking off bedroom that I use as an office. There it is. Bringing it on any little rim you can see. Drop a little highlight on it. Simple shit right there. You know, but the wash is gonna do most of it. And the airbrush gradient we did early in the last week, that's going to kind of carry the effect of this model for the most part. We just got to make sure we come through on some of these harder edges and put an explanation point on it. Vagrant Wolf, oh, you guys, bitch. Yep, you know. So right here in the backpack, this is a clutch spot to drop highlights. Did not do a great job there. And my paint's just a little too watery. We'll let that dry. And then we'll touch it up here in a second. See that? That's more like what I want. There it is. Like I said, you don't want to slack now. Just drop a couple of... Like I said, I call these, like, explanation points. Like... We did all this hard work doing gradation on everything. You just want to give it a little bit more love. These little spikes are a good spot. Spin them around. Finish these highlights on the other sides. This vent right here. We definitely need more paint, less water on this. There we go. Let's see what we got here. There it is. That's what I'm talking about. Pow. Back to the side we fucked up. We'll fix that with a little bit of wash later. We gotta come in there where we fucked up once it dries. Now, underneath that backpack a little bit, you got more opportunities to highlight. Real simple edge highlight shit right here. And I got a little bit on that pipe. That's no big deal. I painted it black. Simple. Spin my wreck around. Do the other side. That easy, guys. And it's okay if I get it on this tubing. Like I said, I painted it black. And so I can just drop a little bit more black over it. So now we got a couple of fun little highlights in the backpack. But you can see it's mainly just still airbrushed. Like, that's the effect we were going for. Like, that going from almost black to red. And now on his chest, there's a couple of things we can do. Dealer off of the death. What is that? Deal or death? I can ask, but they usually don't tell me trade secrets. Oh, sorry. I thought you were telling me. I tell everyone my trade secrets. Just working this highlight in underneath the straps here. Right there. Grabbing a little bit more paint off the palette. Same deal. Now, here's a little trick. It doesn't really make sense for highlighting purposes, but it really helps create contrast. Right here, I'm going to drop a little highlight along the top. Oh, look, it's hard to see. Just kind of like under the strap, just to create a little bit of contrast. You can even go in like basically I just invent highlights at this point. Like right here on his leg right here. I'll draw a little line right here. Just like that. Same way another one. Just simple shit like that, you know? And if you want to get super crazy now, like the problem is like most of his legs are going to be covered because they're going to be sitting on that snowball over there. You can go in and depending on how you felt, you can draw little lines around these arrows. Like that. It's all about how much time you want to put into it. You know, that's like a real subtle, see that? Starting to immediately put a perimeter around that that arrow. Now you come back and do it again. See if I can do another. Yeah, a little bit more orange in there. Just like that. See that? And now it gives you kind of like this three-dimensional look, like it's embedded in the armor. Doesn't take no work at all, man. You know? Papa Smurf. Just watch Scary Terry parts of Rick and Morty. This shit is so funny, isn't it? This show is so funny, dude. All right, on his other leg, I'm going to try to drop the same type of highlight in there. The light's in the wrong position. Just trying to get that tight camera work for you guys. Drop that first line in there. Let it dry for a minute. You can drag some in around the other one. No big deal. I'm gonna go back to, while it's dry, I'm gonna go back to some of this orange color. Drop a little bit of explanation points on the face.
Excellent!
Alright, I'm gonna set that down for 1 second. Make sure I don't fuck anything up. I'm looking at Scary Terry's Lightning Claw here. And I'm noticing that there's a little bit of chunkiness on the claw right here. Some debris in the paint. I think I still have a little bit of white out on the table, so I'm gonna just fix that up real quick. Pull out a different paintbrush. Don't need a super detailed one for this. Sometimes I just can't let shit ride. When I see the mistake, I gotta fix it right away. Okay. Alright, hold on a second. I gotta find my brush soap because my paintbrush needs it right now. And you can see that damn chunky is still there. What the fuck? What the hell is going on there? Sorry, guys. It's like right here. There, I think I got it that time. Not make me happy when this shit like that happens. Okay. Set this down. Damn it, I wanna in between stack for this guy. Here we go. There it is, Scary Terry. Let's set him down for a second. Like I said, I gotta track down this brush soap. I wonder if it's behind here. It is not. Ironhead, where's my brush soap? Tell me. I got a few shout outs to do as well. Motherfucking brush soap. Alright, Eddie, you better know where that motherfucking brush soap is. God damn it. I'm literally the worst. I'm literally the fucking worst. Alright. So that was kind of intense. Gotta see some of the highlight we've been working on right here. We got more time, guys. Don't worry. We're going to do more work. Got the lightning claw looking good. Scary Terry and the gang. Some sick red highlights. All right. Let me see what's been going on here. Real quick, shout out. Amber Lee, thank you for the follow. Appreciate it. Father Lukens, thank you for the follow. Best Thres Kosovo, thank you. Appreciate it. Also, Still Woman Ain't coming clutch, earning billion yo dogs with his $20 donation. Appreciate it. Spiky Bits. You can run, but you can't hide, bitch. Yep, you know what's up. Killing Time Payton, I'll post another photo. Mech Boys Tonight, thanks man, I'm about to check that out. Check that out. Oh, Ironhead, conveniently on the phone. Motherfucker, if it's under that glove, I'll literally beat you down. So mad. Okay, I had to check, it's not under the glove. I was using that motherfucking brush soap today. Like, how does this happen to me? I'm worse than Juice. Taking a quick break, guys. Q&A time. Let's talk. Spiky Bits, the original Gangster Gumbo t-shirt. We've got some pretty good ideas in here so far. Guys, start throwing some of those t-shirt ideas you guys were coming up with for Rob to see at Spiky Bits. Looks like we've got three entries in the four. One, two. We got four. How does it do that? Make sure you guys, if you buy the tickets, make sure you enter the competition. I'm not sure how it tracks it, but I can draw a winner. We've got four people with a total of seven tickets in the raffle right now. That's the math right now. It's going to keep breaking down for the one-on-one painting class. Oh, you guys can post links on the stream now. In case you guys didn't know, I forgot to mention that. Nightbot's dead. We got rid of all that bullshit. Post links on the stream. Anything like that you want me to see. We're not gonna. You don't have to whisper to Ironhead anymore, none of that shit. If you want me to see it, just don't post any bullshit and you won't get timed out. And what do you guys? You guys think I should punch that red up a notch, or do you think I should work on that metal? What are you guys thinking? God, Dumma! I'll check Facebook. Did you message me or did you tag me? Timeline. Are you trolling me on my Facebook page right now? Tagged me. Okay, I'm still searching. I don't think you recognize the volume of things I get tagged in per minute. Like literally 37 notifications in here that have been tagged. It's like, literally never gonna find it. Nope. You're literally going to have to message it to me.
Excellent!
Yura, are you out of here? Oh, thank you. Bobby Boulay coming through with the share. Check Juggernaut's metal iron headed. I gotta mat him down before we work on the metal, so it's not even on the table right now. All right, back to the red guys. Yeah, Spiky Bits knows. Later, Corey Yori Kusanda Kasudan Yori Kasudan. Okay, let's punch this red up, guys. All right, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to get some blazing orange from Vallejo. AKA Bow. Orange fire, sorry. And I'm going to use this in conjunction with the orange we've been using to punch it up a little bit. And it should be pretty cool. We're going to mix them together so we have that common link between the two colors. See how it looks. Okay, now this is going to be a small line in the middle. All right, we're going to grab a little bit more of the orange now that I feel more comfortable with it, because I don't want to go too crazy. There it is. It's a nice line. Okay, okay. Let's go back to Scary Terry's face. Just like that. Down here on this little spot right here we were working on earlier. God damn it, got some bullshit on the paintbrush because I can't find my brush soap. Right here, we're gonna finish that line we were working on. Create that fun effect. Just something like that. Oh. Flip it around to the backpack. Punch up some of these highlights we're working on back here. There it is. Pow! All day. Love it. Getting that pop. Flip this motherfucker around. A fun little corn berserker, man. Ain't even hard to paint. Not even hard. Under Scary Terry's hand. Just right there. Chin. A little more on the brow. And if you want, you can do kind of a similar technique here on the shoulder pad. Yep, tip curl. It's because I don't get that conditioner in my brush right now, man. Ironhead knows. Just mixing up some paints real quick on the palette. Okay, so like, look at the shoulder pad. I hope you can see in there. So you can draw a little line. Right there. Right there. Gives it a fun little effect. Just like that. Keep going around doing little things like that, and then the model just keeps popping out more and more. I bet you can even do one in his little helmet and the tops there. Let's see if I can brace it. I'm gonna see if I can pull this off with our brush in disrepair. All right, so I'm going to try to draw a little fun line right here. All right, nope, not enough paint. Okay, still not enough paint. being careful. God damn it, what the fuck is going on with my paint? It's like I'm trying to be all super careful and then the paint's just not working. There it is. And I'm going to get it on the gold. It's just going to happen. No big deal. I'm not afraid of that. We're just going to reinforce it now with some more orange. Just like that. See that? Right here? Pow! Look at that shit. So fucking easy. Yeah. I don't do enough with the wet palette. But I'm thinking I'm going to have to get a wet palette eventually. No, I think it's... you know what I think the best part of the wet palette is, Ironheaded? I was in Colorado for a long time, bro. It ain't that dry out here. What it is that on stream, I move so much slower that I think I need a wet palette. Getting that look. Get that pure orange out there. Reinforcing these little lines that we're working on. Scary Terry is coming out pretty good. Shit. Let's drop a little bit more pure orange off. Get some of that dopeness. Oh, you know, we totally need to do it on Scary Terry's head. What was I thinking? On the arrow on his head? What was I thinking, guys? I missed out on this. Jay Dirty, what's up, player? So stopping by, man. We got our new emoticons. Somebody ice this guy. We're just drawing some of those lines that we're doing around the arrows on the trim, right around his head. Tiny dog going crazy. She got yelled at. There it is. Close enough. All right, guys. Goddamn paintbrush. Fucking paintbrush soap is gone. So, Scary Terry, we highlighted up in here. We haven't highlighted any of this gold yet. You see, we did this fresh lightning claw. As you can see, spent a lot of time on that. And then we worked on highlighting all this red up on his armor. I'm going to set him down for a second. And we worked on Snowball, his mount. His mount is still a steaming pile of gloss varnish right now that we have to mat back down so we can come in there and highlight all this red up, sneak some red in around these arrows, and do all this gold real quick. But he looks horrible right now because what we talked about here, to summarize, is that gloss varnish plus gloss wash is really good for getting that those dark lines around this trim, but also you're going to want to gloss varnish a pewter model like this to protect it, and then we'll mat it back down. Literally no idea where the paintbrush soap went. Is that right? I think my paintbrush is clean enough until I find my brush soap. Alright guys, sorry for not interacting with you guys. That is so hard for me to do. Joe Dark Blake, what kind of tiny dog do you have? Tiny Dogs Rock. I have a tiny little terrier chihuahua mix. And I love her. Dumbo, are you getting in trouble? Still want my name. I don't know where it is. Killing Time Painting. I'm going to look on the floor. Oh my god. Killing Time Painting. Hold on a second, everybody. This is, he says, check the floor. That's where I found mine the other day. All right, I'm going to move the light over here. Take the shield off. I'm going to move the camera. And what the fuck do you think that is down there? What is that? That's the motherfucking brush soap right there and like three gloves that dropped under my chair. Oh my god. That's some old bullshit right there. He nailed it. Let's get that focus. Too bright. Slow Fuse Gaming, you just now noticed my Galactus? That's my boy right there. All right, well, now that I got this bro soap, that's a big deal. And 1 second, guys. Let me clear out this chat real quick. And guys, you know what time it is, right? First off, we're going to do something we've never done before, guys. Everyone who's on the stream right now, we're going to do our first raid. All right, guys? Now, this is something I've been looking forward to. So we're going to go, after we're done here, we're going to go over to Micho's channel, and we're going to fucking blow him up with Yo Dogs and Icy's. Now, here's how it works. Our bot isn't going to work on his channel. When we host him, just literally, like, go to his channel, because anything you type in chat here, he won't see. We'll host him, then you click on, like, go to his channel. If you're a subscriber, this is where becoming a subscriber matters. You get to use Icy's, Yo Dogs. Literally, open it up and literally just spam it as many, like, I mean, I'm talking, like, literally nonstop. I'm talking, you're not going to stop hitting that button until he gives up, okay? We're going to go over to his channel. We're going to fucking put him on blast. Like, all the subscribers come hither. And just, I mean, talking like flex on this fool, ice him, just, I mean, all day. And they're going to try to fight back with their stupid show balls. But you know, muscle's always going to beat them balls. So, before we do that, though, let's summarize today real quick. And let's talk about the schedule this week. First off, we're streaming on Friday, guys. We're not doing Saturday because I'm going to GT this week. I'm going to film everything. I'm going to take pictures of the games like we talked about. No, it says Ironheaded. I just poked in over to his channel, and I saw him painting some wings just now. So Micho is definitely online streaming right now. I'm just going to double check. Yeah, I can host him. He's live right now with 27 people. So we're going to jump in on him in just 1 second. He was hosting me, probably. So, real quick, guys. Friday, 3:30 p.m., we're going to be streaming. I'm going to put it on everyone on Facebook, on Twitter, so you guys get in there. What I'm thinking about doing is waiting till Friday to finish this guy, even though I'm going to use him at a tournament on Saturday. Old school, motherfucker. Ancient shit right there. Yeah, still one more name. Time for the greatest of all raids. We're about to, I mean, I'm talking relentless attack. Secondly, shout out to all my donators tonight. You guys earned a shitload of Yo Dogs. Big hats off to my man Ironheaded, our fucking mod. He holds it down. He's the one who tracks all that so we can calculate it in for the bonuses, so you guys get your Yo Dog bonus because of donations. Everybody on the stream tonight, you got a Yo Dog per minute that you were on the stream. Don't forget to check out YouTube. Don't forget to check out Twitter, because you get Yo Dogs all week for that. And subscribers get 25 a week. So, without further ado, guys, one last thing. I'm about to host him. Wait till I host him. Okay, wait till I host him. We're going to fuck him up, okay, guys? But I love you guys, and you guys make this possible. It's the last thing I want to say. So I'm going to jump over there. Wait till the host comes through. Then click on go to Micho's channel, Michael Cho's channel, and fucking own this guy. All right, guys. Shit's about to happen. I'm counting it down for you guys. All right. 3, 2, 1. I'm hosting this fool right now. It should go through in about 15 seconds.
As we continue our epic Tuesday of non-stop brush licking and painting miniatures, you guys have an entire day of watching paint dry. Hopefully you guys enjoy the day so far. Look at those ice flexes. Choke balls, look at those choke balls, wreck them. Throw a choke ball right in their eye. Walk over them and say, wrecked. What's going on, everybody? Welcome to the stream. I am Maicho. I'm also a part of Brush Lickers United. We are painting a Blood Angel Death Company Marine, and right now I'm working on the wings right now. Hey, what's going on, Spiky Bits? This is actually a Blood Angel Death Company Marine that we started painting up, and I am painting up the wings to look like so, to go on there. Woohoo! Do I do any terrain? I could. You know, I don't really specialize in terrain, but I can make small sections of like display boards. Hey, what's going on, Slow Fuse? How are you? Oh, look at all that ice. You guys are drowning me in some ice. I'm gonna be drunk. Yeah, if you guys are looking for the soundtrack, it's on the very bottom left corner from where my finger is. Just go straight down, eyeball your way all the way down there, and it'll give you the soundtrack. Thanks a lot. So again, for those of you guys that are just tuning in from Kenny's stream, welcome to the stream. You know, this is one of the things I was just talking about a little while ago about us Brushlicker United team members supporting each other and sending raids and hosts. Today was an epic day of basically streamer after streamer after streamer of painting miniatures. And you guys are watching paint dry, and you guys have an awesome epic day. And we're going to try to schedule that for you guys even more in the upcoming weeks and months. Do you paint the base with it, like the spray can paint? Actually, I don't, Alice. I just brush it on. So this was all primered first. I actually happened to brush primer this model, and then I put the base coat on, which happened to be XV88 brown, and now I'm adding the highlight of Ratskin Flesh. So this is what I would consider my first highlight. And then after the first highlight, I'll put a secondary and a third highlight, and then I'll give the whole thing a wash. Phil Hemsley, thank you for the follow. Welcome to Brush Lickers United. And then after I give the whole thing a wash, I'll go back and then I'll start shading with two layers of shade. Five a.m. and still watching? Nice. Don't go to sleep, just get a Red Bull. Oh, okay, Vargrant Wolf, thank you for that, suggestion. I pretty much stream right now, currently. I stream Monday, or basically, let me say this.